Your career's had a lot of good times, and it's had some tough times, but we all want to know where Stevie Richards goes from here.
Well, first of all, I have had some good times along with some bad times, Jeff Gorman. But let me say one thing. It feels really damn good to be here with all you people in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. As a matter of fact, I did come here to Pittsburgh for one specific reason. There's something that everybody here has been shortchanged for a long time. Well, I'm about to tell you what it is. Anyway, a lot of people for years, especially the past 1 or 2 years, have said, Stevie, Dancing Stevie, what would ever happen if you were face to face in the ring with the King of the Independents, the Reckless Youth? So what I want to do right here, right now, tonight, is make a challenge to Reckless Youth. One fall to a finish. Now, if he wants to come out and answer my challenge, this is a...
Need a tow?
Professional wrestling. Do you want to be on television? Then you better be at Steel City Wrestling on Sunday, November 22nd at 6 o'clock for its next television taping at the SCW Arena in Irwin, located directly off of the Pennsylvania Turnpike, exit 7, or 25 minutes from Pittsburgh, just off of the Parkway East on Route 30. Your main event, the Blue Meanie from Extreme Championship Wrestling and a mystery partner will take on High Society. The winners will be the new tag team champions. Plus Reckless Youth, Don Montoya, Cody Michaels, Denny Gregory, and all the stars of Steel City Wrestling. 734-8454 for tickets and information. Sunday, November 22nd, live television taping, 6 o'clock.
I'm joined now by Cody Michaels, and Cody, you've really developed your own style, a very tough style over the years, not just here in Steel City Wrestling, but in Memphis and in ECW as well.
I have developed a style, and it's kind of an offshoot of what I've been trained to do. You know, being trained by legendary great Dominic DiNucci, and being trained with the likes of Shane Douglas, Cactus Jack, you get a lot of different styles of wrestling. At the same time, you know, when you speak of Memphis and the great tag team that I had to work with Jeff Jarrett down there, there is a definite style differential. And it's kind of like coming to Steel City Wrestling and not fitting in.
Yeah, and it seems like things really haven't fit in as far as the officiating. You've had your problems with Chris Wood. In fact, you're just coming off a suspension where Chris Wood went to the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission and complained about you attacking him.
Chris Wood, you are a piece of garbage. The lowest trailer trash life I've ever seen. In all my years of wrestling, I have had many setbacks. I have had many broken bones. I've laid in hospitals with a broken neck, not knowing if I would move again. But there's one thing that gets me about this sport of wrestling. It's people like you with no experience, no respect, that try to run roughshod over everyone in a promotion. Let me tell you something, you piece of garbage. When it comes time to get into the ring, you stick your nose into my match, you are going to get a chair over your head. You stick your nose into anyone else's matches, you are going to get a chair over your head. Let me make one thing clear. Cody Michaels has been around for a long time and knows how to get the job done. And brother, you are a Jay Brone and you will do a job.
And we'll see how this vampire, Vladimir Vampire, fares against Cody Michaels, who's about to make his way out here. Michaels, a very tough veteran.
Now, Cody Michaels, one of my favorites, wrestled for many years in many different federations. He's, you know, he's not exactly in the prime of his career, Jeff, but he still has plenty to beat this loser with. I might add, if I could shout out a good well wish to Cody Michaels and my very good friend, Brian C. Hildebrand, a.k.a. WCW referee Mark Curtis, has to undergo some surgery in the near future. Hopefully he'll be all right, and we'll keep you posted on him. There's the bell. I like Cody Michaels to win this one. What about you, Jeff?
I would have to say he's the favorite, yes.
Hailing from Midian, weighing in at 193 pounds, Vladimir Vampire!
I don't like this ring announcer, not one bit. I don't like him.
Jamie Scott.
Hailing from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 222 pounds, Cody Michaels!
Jeff Gorman here along with Mark Madden for Steel City Wrestling. We're about to see Cody Michaels returning to SCW. He was actually suspended for all those attacks on Chris Wood. Wood went to the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission and got Michaels suspended, and now Cody Michaels is back.
Well, Cody Michaels, a fierce, rugged competitor, was even deemed a little too dangerous for ECW.
Whoa.
When he spent time in their big hip toss out of the corner. Totally a wild man. That's a combination I like a lot.
Not bad work if you can get it, as Cody Michaels rams Vampire into the post, and this is his style. He's not going to change from this style.
He's he's got a chair. He's got a chair.
Now, no Chris Wood around here to stop him that time.
Well, Chris Wood's a very shady individual. I've already notified the FBI, the CIA, the DEA, the NRA, all the associations I can think of about his chicanery. He's a four-flushing charlatan as far as I'm concerned.
Look at that.
And just the fact, oh, Cody Michaels comes off the apron and just crushes Vampire. Chris Wood, not to prolong my rant here, Jeff, very dangerous man.
As Cody Michaels sends Vampire back into the ring, this is a new referee in SCW, Paul Turner, and I guess he's not really sure how much he should let people get away with here, because Michaels has the chair in the ring right now.
I notified the IRA and Slippery Rock College as well about Chris Wood.
That was probably a good idea. And a DDT on the chair. Good
night. What a move. A leaping, jumping DDT right on the wood. Easy three count for Cody Michaels.
Cody Michaels. Back in SCW with a vengeance. It's like he was wrestling Chris Wood in there the way he went at him, like with a chair.
Cody Michaels came out tonight like he had something to prove. He's being screwed around by Chris Wood. The Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission. Don't forget, Cody Michaels didn't just ride in on the turnip truck. He was a killer when he was in Memphis, where they brawl all night long. No surprise there. This vampire guy doesn't. Who's this? Oh, is that Zoltan?
Yeah. Lord Zoltan in the ring, coming out, I believe, to the aid of Vladimir Vampire.
I see Zoltan got a new outfit, huh?
I think so. I hope you can see through that thing.
Is that definitely Lord Zoltan? I can't tell from this angle. I was giving the Lord Zoltan salute. Either that or Heinrich Himmler's back in town.
Uh-oh. And it looks like Zoltan is kind of taking Vampire under his wing. And that might be a good idea for the Vampire.
Vampire could use some guidance. He kind of has that twisted personality that makes you a bit unstable in a ring, Jeff. Well, Jeff, this is it, the Battle of the Independent Kings.
Oh, yeah.
Reckless Youth, Stevie Richards, here comes Dancing Stevie. It's almost like it's Independence Day here at the Steel City Wrestling Arena.
And look at that.
Here's Stevie Richards. Stevie, how about a few words for the fans at home?
No comment.
Stevie Richards, folks, still as loquacious as ever.
Definitely. Stevie's ready for business. He actually called out Reckless Youth for this match. He wants to know if he can deal with the current King of the Independents, Reckless Youth.
Well, Stevie Richards, in his own right, was the King of the Independents long before there ever was a Reckless Youth. Then he went to ECW, competed there, became a character unto himself, one of the most stunning original characters. Not a 70s gimmick, not a 70s rehash, not an 80s gimmick. Stevie Richards is truly 90s, and it's amazing that this man does not have a job in the big time right now.
And you can say the same thing for this guy, Reckless Youth. Unbelievable talent that belies his size. Really, people don't even care about his size anymore. He's just that good.
Of course, it's also amazing to me that Stevie's not in prison now, too.
Introducing first.
Let's go to the idiot.
From Philadelphia,
Jamie Scott.
Weighing in at 224 pounds, he is the original King of Swing, Dancing Stevie Richards! And the opponent from Babylon, New York, weighing in at 199 and 3/4 pounds, Reckless Youth!
I just want to say, Jeff Gorman, Stevie Richards referred to himself as the original King of Swing. I, of course, use that name on my wildly popular talk show on Sports Radio 1250 right here in town, 4 to 8 every day of the week. I coined that name and rented it to Stevie Richards. In Pittsburgh, I am actually the original King of Swing.
Oh, really? Reckless Rule says Reckless Youth, and we're going to find out in this match.
Now let's call this match tight, Jeff. We got two good workers in there. Let's go nuts.
Okay. Stevie Richards getting the fans behind him. Both these two very popular, very respected here in SCW. Stevie getting the fans going as they lock up. Stevie backing Reckless in. And we're going to get a clean break.
Two very good sportsmen here. They may look like the dregs of society, but they're willing to have a nice clean match.
Stevie Richards, the two-time tag team champion, once with Frank Stiletto and once with the Blue Meanie here in Steel City. As they lock up once again, side headlock. Of course, Reckless Youth has held the junior heavyweight title here before. But both these two, so much talent, capable of beating anybody at any time, including each other. This one could really go either way.
Stevie gets up with the head scissors now. Reckless Youth trying to get up, trying to cradle Stevie. Stevie backs up. Stevie now rolls them up. What a move by Stevie. Reckless rolls him up. They're trading roll-ups. Unbelievable. A bunch of quick counts. I never thought the referee could count that quickly. Single leg takedown.
Boy, this, and a stalemate.
What good, clean, pure scientific wrestling. I don't like it. I love it.
And that's what Stevie said. He says, I'm not out here to try to kill you or try to hurt you. I just want to know if I can beat you.
Yeah, but if it comes down to it, he may kill him, may try to hurt him. Once you get in there, you lose your head. It's survival of the fittest. I think this match will turn into a roughhouse event before it's all over.
Oh, I wouldn't be surprised at all. Stevie backing Reckless into the corner. And no clean break there as the forearm to the head and another one by Richards. And Irish Whip is reversed by Reckless and takes them over and down. And Reckless off the rope into a beautiful snapping neck breaker on the way down. Of course.
Kind of like a buff blockbuster only on the mat.
Yeah.
Great move by Reckless Youth.
Leg drop there.
Obviously, Reckless Youth going after Stevie Richards' neck. Series of elbow drops, a buff blockbuster on the mat. He's going to go after that neck because Stevie Richards, hey, it's no secret, Jeff. He's had a multitude of surgeries on that neck. Still hasn't totally recovered. His voice still shows the strain. And now he's yanking that neck up under the chin, big hard front face lock by Reckless Shoot.
And it's really dangerous for Richards to be in there for a variety of reasons, but especially considering Reckless's finishing hold, the stretch plum, that could really jack Richards out of shape if Reckless is able to apply.
No doubt about it, but one thing, Stevie Richards, a pretty well-kept secret how big he is, kind of tall and gangly, has pretty good musculature. It's going to be tough for Reckless at his height to get Stevie Richards in the stretch plum.
Reckless now elbowing his way out. Actually, Richards elbowing his way out of trouble. And a sleeper applied.
Going to be tough to hold it. Stevie's too tall. Stevie can power out because of his height.
Plus, he's not really worn down, but it looks like Reckless is trying to wear Stevie down with this hold.
Now Reckless has a shot here. He has him on the mat, Jeff.
Reckless really trying to cinch that one in. And both these guys really have a lot to prove. I believe this is the first time they've ever wrestled each other anywhere.
First time at anywhere, any arena, anywhere in the world. It's a heck of a match. These people at the Sideshow Pizza Place got more than pepperoni when they showed up today.
I'll say, and I'm very proud to be part of Steel City Wrestling, bringing you a match of this caliber. And Stevie trying to get himself back into this match. Reckless trying desperately to hang on to this one. But like you said, the tall, gangly body of Richards able to help him power out, and now Richards with a sleeper.
Now Stevie has the height advantage, even though they're both standing. Oh, great sit-out move by Reckless Youth, and that got right up under Stevie's chin and neck. He's hurt bad.
And Reckless is going right after that area over and over and over again. Rams him into the top turnbuckle. What's Reckless going to go for here? Pounding down. Nine.
You kids at home, don't watch that.
Oh boy. Where's that blue dot when you need it? Sends him across, reversed by Richards. Down goes Reckless. Wait a minute, here we go. There goes the bottom rope.
Oh, for heaven's sakes, the bottom rope is broken. Reckless Youth may be hurt bad. Stevie Richards has taken Reckless Youth for the ultimate Bronco ride.
I'll say he has taken the ring apart. The bottom rope is gone here, and the fans appreciating that, the force with which it flies out of the DDT by Reckless.
I always wondered how necessary that bottom rope was. Now we get to find out, I guess.
Yeah, no one really bounces off the bottom rope to do something, but a two count. But no one will be able to put their foot on the bottom rope for leverage.
Very good.
To get out of a pin.
You know what? This shows what great announcers we are, Jeff Gorman. An unbelievable circumstance has come up, and we have all the bases covered on what could happen.
As if it happened all the time. Reckless has Stevie up on the top rope right now.
That was a headbutt to the nether regions.
Ow.
Oh, my Lord.
Super Frankensteiner by Reckless. One, two, and a two count. Referee Paul Turner just slamming his hand through the mat on these counts.
You know what? What a great match is this, Jeff Gorman. It is my stated goal to get both these competitors to WCW, a great federation where I make big money.
They would both be proud to have these two guys run, splash nobody home. Richards out of the way.
Reckless Youth, he has a lot of ring savvy, but his ego got the best of him there. Waited too long to go for the frog splash, and now both competitors are very worn down, very hurt. I think Reckless Youth hit chin first on the mat there.
Reckless trying to make his way back to his feet, but Stevie Richards is up first. Steady as he goes, and exchanging right hand. Stevie now beating Reckless with a punch. A little flip off and fly into the falling front kick.
Oh my God!
Boy, both these two are going to be walking very funny tomorrow.
What do you mean tomorrow? They're walking funny now.
Right. Stevie sends Reckless for the spinning side. Two count, Reckless kicks out.
I think Stevie thought he had a one there, an expression of disbelief after Reckless got out at 2 3/4.
And it's amazing that Stevie, with all the problems he's had, with all of his neck problems, that he can still wrestle at this top caliber. Jackknife powerbomb coming up. Stevie bomb!
One, two! Oh, I thought he got him!
Barely Reckless Youth kicks out of a Stevie bomb. Unbelievable.
You know, never mind the physical problems, Jeff Gorman. Stevie Richards got the emotional problems, the psychological problem. The man's been in a straitjacket half of his life. I made that up, but it sounded good. Stevie kick!
Here comes
the Stevie kick!
He's loading it up. Is Reckless Youth going to take the Stevie kick? Here we go! after.
That'll do it. One, two. Oh! Oh! I thought he had him. He blocked the Stevie kick guard, the chart buster. Oh, my God. Somebody give me a beer. This is taking it all out of me.
But Stevie kicked out. I can't believe that. Calling for a tornado DDT now, maybe. Reckless feels he's got Stevie in a compromising position. We'll see if he can hit this tornado DDT. Stevie's like dead weight.
He's like a limp dish rag. He's going to be tough to tornado DDT Stevie. You need a little bit of life in the legs for this move.
Here we go. Reckless setting it up. No!
Stevie played possum, threw him off. What a great defensive move.
There it is.
Stevie kick! Stevie kick! He got him! He go! Oh, no!
Reckless kicked out of a Stevie kick.
He hit him with the Stevie bomb, the Stevie kick, everything but the Stevie sink in this match, Jeff Gorman.
I'll say. And Stevie doesn't know what he has to do. I think he thought that he had Reckless with that move right there.
Well, now, what else is left in Stevie's arsenal now?
I know. We'll have to see. He may have to pull out a Stevie chair or something.
Or a Stevie foreign object.
Could be. What's he going to set Reckless up for here? Amazing that Reckless is still in this match. He's going to set him up on top.
Oh, Reckless going upstairs. Reckless is dead weight now. Maybe he's playing possum too, Jeff.
His eyes seem to be rolling around. Ouch. That could be a problem.
Interesting offensive maneuver there. In fact, I haven't seen a maneuver more offensive.
I'm personally offended by it. Stevie on the top rope. Actually on the second rope now, but Reckless able to fight his way out. Down goes Richard. Frog splash!
He got him! One, two, three, yeah. That'll do it! Reckless Youth is truly the king of the independents, but what a match! Two of the best, like Stevie said, not two of the best independents, two of the best damn wrestlers going.
Amen.
And they gave the fans all they wanted, and maybe a little more. Reckless Youth, your winner, but both men came out of this a little better than they were before the match started.
Listen up, Pittsburgh.
People, a lot of people were talking about Stevie Richards and Reckless Youth. And I know you people came here to see a hell of a match tonight. And I hope you were happy.
I'm happy.
I won't be happy until I get paid, but it was a hell of a match.
Yeah.
Stevie, a lot of these people might not know, but there's a lot of crap going around this business talking about you and I. But regardless of what everybody else says, I know, you know, and these people know that we're damn good workers. Brother, you gave me a hell of a match. Thank you very much.
Oh, shake his hand, you big baby.
Yeah. There you go.
At Hungry Frank's, our customers are the best at
champion, Lightning Mike Quackenbush. And Mike, it was a fantastic aerial match where you won the title. You had to go through Reckless Youth and the previous champion, Christian York. One of the most amazing aerial matches I've ever seen.
Thanks, Jeff. When the three-way dance all came together, and I looked across the ring, and it was Reckless Youth, and I was the current champ, Christian York, I realized I was in for one of the toughest nights of my life. But maybe with a little bit of lady luck and a little bit of hard work on my side, I managed to beat not only Christian using the top rope Tiger Driver, but I also managed to pin Reckless Youth with my own coup de grace, the Quacken Driver, and I walked out of there with the Steel City Wrestling Junior Heavyweight title.